You say that Larry Elder is the clear favorite on the other side.
Yeah.
So I think there are a lot of people that have asked me, how much can a governor really do in a year with a Democratic supermajority? What's the answer to that?
I mean, you can lie down and veto everything coming out of the legislature. You can veto everything that comes from the legislature.
But there's a veto-proof majority, right?
Well, there is and there isn't. A lot of things are stubborn. There's a lot of diversity even within the Democratic caucus. At the end of the day, you could start to vandalize all the executive orders. You can eliminate the masking requirement for public schools. You can eliminate the vaccine requirements for public health care workers. So many of the things that I signed through executive order can be done overnight. You can appoint judges without any oversight and consideration. That's going to have an impact for years and years and years. If there's a vacancy, and you've seen many vacancies, Secretary of State, U.S. Senator, you've seen an Attorney General, you appoint County Board of Supervisors. I appoint half a dozen. You able to appoint people that will permanently have that opportunity to represent. So it is a profound consequence. And also you have the bully pulpit of the fifth largest economy in the world. And you have a midterm election coming up with another California who wants to take out Nancy Pelosi. Consequences are pretty extraordinary.